Let's start the second topic for this session. You saw the one important factor which determines working capital requirements is your operating cycle or working capital cycle. Now, what is operating cycle or working capital cycle? How fast it takes for cash to come back in your business? Now, if you talk about a manufacturing company, how do they manufacture? They have cash. From cash, they start purchasing raw materials, right? So raw materials are purchased. Then raw materials are converted to semi-finished goods, that is work in progress. Then semi-finished goods are converted to finished goods and have a stock of finished goods. These finished goods are sold in the market, right? They can be sold in cash, they can sold on credit. Cash is okay, the cycle gets complete. But when they sell on credit, what happens? It arises to debtors, and when debtors pay back cash, then you can start up your working capital cycle again. So if you see over here, this is how a working capital cycle or operating cycle of a company is. And every organization want to have a shorter working capital cycle because it takes fast for you to get back your money back in your business. For example, if I say my working capital for cycle for my company is 82 days, my competitors are 60 days. It means somewhere I'm lacking behind. My competitors can get the money, they do the manufacturing, everything, get back the money in 60 days. If higher the production cycle or operating cycle is bad for a company, and every company strive to reduce it. So what do we do now? We try to find out how much time is blocked at every stage, right? How much time is lost from cash to come in? When you get cash, how much time you lose in purchasing raw materials, then converting to finished good, then converting to finished good and selling and getting the cash back, right? So we have various stages in the operating cycle of a company. We have a raw material stage, we have as a work in progress stage, we have a finished good stage, you have debtors collection period, and you have creditors payment period. When you purchase raw material, you can purchase on cash, you can purchase on credit. So you also have to pay these people tomorrow. So how do you find out the operating cycle of a company? Raw material stage, add back work in progress stage, add back finished good, add debtors collection period, minus creditors payment period, minus the creditors payment, because this is a time you are taking time to increase your cycle. So minus the time which you have to pay. Find it out the total working capital cycle. So add up the four stages minus the last creditors payment period, you get the final operating cycle of a company. Let us see how do we find out the operating cycle of a company. The first thing, what do we need? We need to find out is a raw material stage. Raw material stage, how do we find? Average stock of raw material divided by raw material consumption per day, right? Now remember cost sheet which you studied before, same we have to relate it over here. So raw materials are related to raw material consumption. So how do you find raw material stage? Average stock of raw material divided by average raw material consumption per day. Similarly, how do you find work in progress stage? Average work in progress stock divided by average cost of production per day. How do you find finished goods stage? Average finished goods stock divided by average cost of goods sold per day. Right? Similarly, how do you find debtors collection period? Average debtors divided by average credit sales per day. What are debtors related to? Credit sales. So start finding out the days at every stage. Creditors are related to what? How much you credit purchases. So how do you find creditors payment period? Average creditors divided by average credit purchases per day. Add up your raw material, add up your work in progress, add up your finished good. Add up your debtors minus your creditors payment period, you get the final operating cycle of a company. Remember, raw materials are related to raw material consumption, work in progress is related to cost of production, finished goods related to cost of goods sold, debtors to credit sales. Let us do a small illustration together to see how do we find out operating cycle in days. Let us do a small illustration to actually find it out. Let's do this illustration together. From the following information extracted from the books of a manufacturing company, compute the operating cycle in days. They're very clear to find out in days. Let's see what information is given to us. Period covered is 365 days. Average period of credit period allowed by suppliers is 16 days. So if you see credit, this payment period is already given to you, that is 16 days. Average total of debtors outstanding is 450. Raw material consumption is 4,400. Total production cost is 10,000. Cost of sales is 10,500. Sales for the year is 16,000. Credit sales is not mentioned. Assume total sales is credit sales. Let us see what else is given to you. Value of average stock maintained of raw material is 320. Work in progress is 350. Finished good is 250. Based on this information which is given to us, we need to find out the operating cycle. Whenever you find the operating cycle, go step by step. What do we in the first step? We find out is the raw material stage, right? So find out the first thing we need to find out is the raw material stage. Raw material stage, how do we find? average stock of raw material divided by average raw material consumption per day, right? Let us see how much stock of raw material we have over here. If you see, the average stock of raw material given to us is 320, right? How much is average raw material consumption per day? The given to us is 4,400. So keep the formulas handy. So 320 divided by 4,400. We need to find out in days. How many days are there in a year? 365. Multiply by 365, you get as the raw material stage, that is 27 days. Keep it clear. Let's go to the second one, work in progress stage. How do we find work in progress stage? Average work in progress divided by average cost of production per day. Average work in progress given to us is 350. Average cost of production given to us is 10,000. So 350 divided by 10,000 into 365, because we need to find out in days, we'll get is 13 days as work in progress stage. Let's go to the next. Where will your product go next? Raw material done, work in progress done, will go to finished goods stage. How do you find finished goods stage? Average finished goods divided by average cost of goods sold per day. Average finished goods, how much do we have? We have is 260. Average, similarly, we need is cost of goods sold over here. So average finished goods divided by average cost of goods sold over here. How much is average cost of goods sold given to us over here is, you can see is given to us is 10,500. So 200 divided by 10,500. How many days are there in a year? 365 multiplied by 365 over here. You get over here is what? Your finished goods stage, which you sum it up, will get us how much? 9 days. Continue. Raw material done, work in progress done, finished goods done. Where will you start selling? If you sell on credit, how would you need to find debtors collection period? How do you find debtors collection period? Average debtors divided by average credit sales. If you see average debtors, how much do we have is 480. How much is average sales? Total sales is given. Assume total sales is credit sales is 16,000. Multiply by 365 for the number of days, you get us 11 days as your debtors collection period. Now, add up your raw material, add up your work in progress, add up your finished good. Add up your debtors collection period minus creditors payment, which you have already given to us is 16 days. If you add and subtract consecutively, you get 44 days as operating cycle for this company. It means for this organization, for cash to come back in, how much time does it take? It takes us 3 out of 365, it takes 44 days to come back for a one operating cycle as such. It means for 44 days, your money is blocked in a business. Now, if you want to find out how many operating cycles are there in a year, 365 days are there in a year, 44 days, one operating cycle day. So how much operating cycles will you have in a year? 365 divided by 44, that is 8.3 cycles happen in a year. Now, if you want to know how much working capital is also required for it, for a one operating cycle, how much you do? If you remember, total cost is given to you was how much cost of sales? It means total cost was 10,500. One operating cycle is 8. Number of operating cycles in a year is 8.3. So how much will be the amount of working capital required? 10,500 divided by 8.3 as such. This is how you do is working capital estimate and finding out the operating cycle of a company. Keep it clear, add up every stage. Raw material, work in progress, finished good, add up debtors minus the creditors. Raw material related to is what? Raw material purchased. Debtors are related to credit sales. Creditors are related to credit purchases. Work in progress to cost of production. Finished goods to cost of goods sold. Keep your concepts clear, and that is how we find out is the operating cycle of a company.